on three hangers and all three doors.
Thank you. Oh! Hey, what's going on?
Not too much. I'll tell Christian what we're doing. There's
a lot of room.
I mean,
you just
have to stop. Might as well just all mount up and start giving each other hugs. I don't want to.
You'll be, yeah.
Is that the Granite City?
Granite City.
Yeah.
Have you never seen both
of them?
It isn't even
this long. Here's the deal. This is an indoor soccer place. Yeah. So, I mean, how much soccer equipment do you need to get dressed in the locker?
Yeah.
ice are on the side of the ice, got my ice, and skated across to the bench. Jeremy was freaking and pissed off, screaming and yelling, and went off to the bench while two people went down and had a break. 100% her fault that we lost that game. Then they lost, or they... And then they beat Merrimack 7-1 and beat Merrimack 6-2. So who knows? It's kind of up in the air.
Until I knew that, you know, yeah.
We got our letter from the health department that said there's no possibility.
Oh, they said we're good.
There's no possibility you can get COVID to anyone.
Okay.
And you're good. You don't have to basically, we are good for 6 to 9 months that they know of right now. Because they can't get any further because they don't know.
It's been 9 months,
so they're saying that nobody is sitting with it's COVID. It's like not even a half a percent of people are getting it.
Okay.
It's not even getting
it. The media's making it a lot worse than it is.
There's no way they're gonna.
Hi! Hey, look at them! They're standing at the doorway. They're like,
their dog is out.
I just tried to just let it go.
We're like in there like every 4 to 6 weeks.
Well,
like
that's
our
the way I used to be like that. It was like every 4 weeks I had a standing appointment to go get my hair cut. And I'd spend a shit ton of money on getting highlights, perms, a whole bunch of stuff. And I keep doing that. Then I get more of it. Shaved, cut short.
Yeah.
Always wore like that. And then one of the ladies that cuts my hair at the door cuts it. Yeah. So I'm going to go on. I probably should.
Yeah, I swear we lived in the business of the four of us going so often. Oh, they are? Oh my God.
I'm not sure that maybe this is a separate thing.
Who?
I mean, it's too hard about it.
No,
they
must be
right.
North Arkansas is in Milwaukee. Oh my God.
But
they usually come, you don't have to travel to them, and usually they have to come up, and usually they get like four or six games in a weekend. So it's like tournament.
That's what I was looking for.
No.
Where can we ever end? I've never been there. Springfield, Missouri.
Springfield, Missouri.
I call it. I am driving 4 hours.
Every single time we have a league game.
For one game.
Even my goalie. Well, no, we can't make it till we get up. He said, damn the luck. We drive 4.5 hours for an hour game. We drive 4.5 hours home.
No.
Not once did we ever make that trip.
No.
Nick went one time in the coach.
My oldest,
coming down 44 in a nice storm.
And he was 18.
No. 44 already makes me nervous.
He was 18.
I hate 44. I feel scared.
He was 18.
Oh, no.
Rode down with this coach.
No.
And the coach is, you know, a friend, so it was fine. But he got back and he goes, I white knuckled the whole way home.
Oh.
It was ice. It was an ice storm the whole time.
I can't even imagine. When me and Alex tried driving to
last year.
Yes.
Yeah.
We took them, what did you take, you guys? Hours. We would have probably made it, but we would have got stuck on 40 right before the Daniel Boone Bridge. So I had to back up on the highway to get off. And then I went around and I went down 141 out to 70. And then when I got out there, I'm moving about 2 miles an hour. I go, this bad here. I go, I'd hate to see what it's like out in Kansas City.
We did that. I mean, just for a practice one time at Centene.
Yeah.
Tony was out of town and I had both kids and it was like January. Snowy, cars were sliding up the road. I got like 20 minutes from my house and it took like 40 minutes to get there. And I go, I'm turning around.
Absolutely.
And he's like, I can't believe it. And he's like, I can't believe you. Everybody else is going. And all of a sudden it starts blowing up and everybody's not showing up. He goes, oh, I didn't think it was that bad. I'm like, get out of here in town.
Well, that's just it though. I mean, it was bad. I mean, it just all sucked because I left.
Part of the problem is he ended up leaving his great niece's birthday party and they left early to make sure that he would get there. And they ended up getting stuck in traffic after accident after accident. And he's just like, but I'm not
here. Well, there was no snow until I got out. Once they got into Chesterfield, that's when all the snow started coming down. Then there was an accident on the bridge and had the bridge shut down. So I backed up almost a mile on the shoulder. It got off at the outlet mall and turned around.
Wow, that's crazy.
And then tried going a different way.
And I was like, you know what? I go, there's no way.
I wonder what this winter is going to be like. Do you have snow days anymore?
Yeah.
Oh. Because they are saying this year we will have them, but next year we won't. They're just going to push out virtual stuff.
Now, see, and what's funny is a lot of school districts said no to
them. I love snow days. They're fun.
I'll give you some work on Google Classroom, but if you think I'm doing these 4-hour weekend Zoom, you're crazy.
Well, they told us, our principals told us last Wednesday, our work day, get 3 weeks of packets ready, just in case. That was a 14-hour day, because I had 3 hours of meetings, and then the rest of that time was spent getting these packets ready. We're not using them for still in person. I'm like, oh my god, I could scream. So all these kids are bringing these packets back, and I'm sorting them all out. And I'm like, here's your morning work, here's your math work. I'm like, I want to scream.
Problems, man. These kids ain't getting nothing out of
this. They're not getting any in. I mean, you have to admit, are you getting through as much this year as you have in the past?
I can't, because I only have my kids 2 days a week.
And not only that, I have mine 5 days a week, and you still can't. Because when you have them in class, I don't
but
know about you.
But yours are older, too, and yours didn't have that whole semester, quarter last year.
But on top of that, like I told Dan, so we get to school, we get all our morning stuff done, and I get on a Zoom. We get off the Zoom, they go to a restroom break. We get done with the restroom break, we come back, we eat snack, we go outside for morning recess, we come in, and then we have 55 minutes till it's lunchtime, but about 10:45, I have to bring them to another restroom break to wash their hands for lunch. Oh, but after recess, we have to wash our hands too. Go to the bathroom and wash our hands. So then after that, so we get back after recess.
10 years ago.
Yeah, I don't
after
have
recess, we come in and they have to wash their hands. Then we get on another Zoom.
What's going on, man?
And then all of our special classes are in the afternoon. And then we have another restroom break sometime in that afternoon. Because we can't send them one at a time. We have to do full class restroom breaks so they can spray down the bathrooms with they have a sprayer with antibacterial spray. Basically a big huge Lysol.
Okay.
So we have 4 restroom breaks. 2 we absolutely have to do because it's after they come in from recess and they have to wash their hands.
You're waiting 5 years on how many people are gonna have issues from all this Lysol.
We have our own bathroom.
Oh, okay.
So I don't have that issue at all.
Yeah, and every restroom break takes 10 to 15 minutes. You know that. You've done a restroom break sometime in your life. You know that it's not quick.
Well, we used to do that, even though we have a single bathroom in our room. Because it used to still take a poop, you know? And what I've there is, because I have so many animals, you know, because they're so little, but they said it would be like, absolutely not. There are specific times that teachers are
there. So, I feel like all I do is spend my day wiping desks off.
And going pee.
That's what I'm doing. Wash your hands. Go to the bathroom and wash your hands.
No, I'm just stressed because I have to get twice as much done in half the time. You know what I mean? Like 2 hours.
Well, the kids are so far behind from missing a whole semester.
Like, their parents don't work with them for me. I'm true. Because that's half of them. More than half of them. Uh-huh. Week is not with their parents.
So I have a little girl who she's gone to sleep quite a few times and does sleepovers and that. But she can't come to school.
You told me that.
Wait, I'm gonna pull up her grades for this semester.
Well, they told all of ours if you're not doing it, you're all virtual and you do nothing, you're coming into school after forcing all of them.
Oh, are they making them come in?
So there was 20-something second graders coming in, and one teacher had all of them. And like all the staff of the teacher were in one class, and that's
the first day. Better than mixing them in with the other kids.
Yes, but that would have been an instructor to get any kids for us support, you know? And those kids are gonna be low.
So
they didn't do any work.
Our whole,
you know.
But I blame the parents.
Absolutely.
Blame the parents.
I mean, we got them.
Okay, here. Now, this is her grades for, and they're actually better because she's been doing work for a little bit. This is her grades for second floor. Okay, religion, a 20% F.
What?
And reading.
You got your beer, huh?
Always.
48, huh?
Always.
You had to start sneaking them into the Centene Center.
I know. I didn't do it last time, and I was like, I'm just like, fingers crossed, the rest of telling them again.
Social
they won't be selling them until after the same page.
Science, 17%. Wait, it gets better. It gets better. Music?
Yeah, I'll just have a vending machine.
Or beer?
What my buddy did, he ended up picking up a vending machine and got it all cleaned up and everything. He set it out in the garage. And I think he's got like 530 packs back there. Just go up and hit the button and just spit the beer. Keeps it cold. This is the canned beer.
You have a
pull it up.
What's that?
You have a bag. It doesn't understand the material. It's an
empty
cooler
thing that you can
just
like
find out
for.
Oh, that's it.
My friend told me that who owns
your right. I mean, I have a kid who has a kid
who
has a
new one.
He has six kids.
That's your name first?
Never once.
Yes. Bears down the sleeves of your shirts and walk into the
It's a big tube. And I'm like, what did I do?
So,
they don't search these girls because the conductor
Luke said 6'8".
And so he, I would put him up on the sides of the booth right here, the two plaques.
I can't tell you how many times my brother ended up in that position.
We had a friend of ours, she's stuck in a pit of
she put
the pit between the boobs. Robin.
Oh
at
yeah.
At Point Fest.
I put it at the bottom. Like right here.
We're telling
this
you.
This is all boob right here.
No. So
and then, like, then she'd walk in.
And then
so then one time we did this thing where we just put like two flasks and one right here, and then we had like little shots in my bra. I was like,
all right,
it needs
what?
I'm gonna
touch
it on my bra.
Like,
right on the goal line
with the stick.
Like, you know, it'd almost be better if he was, like,
smaller.
I know I have
two
kids, if he was smaller. But if he was smaller, then you could have been
oh, my God.
Oh, my God. We're about to have a hard time. Congratulations. You leave that?
I mean,
no one's gonna question if you leave
that
you have a smaller bra. I'm like, oh, my God. I was
just
like, oh, I saw 3,000
people
in your face. Your face.
I always
have. Your face, and
I
was like, your face.
I'd always wear baggy pants and last call. You always have one in your hand and two in your pocket.
No, I would see. I think everyone's.
Oh my God, this is so awesome. I'm still watching the Rossi replay.
Oh my God, there was a kid on our team and I felt so bad for him. I was going to his mom and I was like,
what were you going to go for this whole time? That's what I want to know.
Well, and the cool thing is, right? So. One of our moms has a hotspot on her phone. Okay. She has like unlimited data. So all that's on Facebook. So the GoPro streams to Facebook Live. So right here.
Oh,
we're
in
the new Bronco.
We have this game.
If we factor the 13. Yeah, even the ones that are small, they've been better than what that is. He's like, no,
he's
from his dad's
house. So
there's
a. She's
divorced. So I'm like,
well, oh my God.
And it all does it from the
camera. Freezing outside in
10:32. We were outshot 37-5. One of the goals was our own kid. Goals were.
I grew up with nothing.
I heard about it.
That's why she's like, his paint was going to play today.
No, they called for him
tomorrow.
But I was like, if you need, don't call him Barrett.
Okay. The A2 playing again.
Okay.
And then paint's
like, Walmart, or
Walmart.
He came
right up to the car and he was
you're starting to.
Okay.
I can't think.
And I'm like,
okay.
But this kid is this big. And not even lying in this
and then you gotta go from the straight
his
to there.
His mom buys some of these clothes that
yeah, we bought
clean.
Yeah.
They're either all the ridiculously so big or so small that it fell in. And
I still only heard from my own. I just
think I'm cool. And I said, can you find out what size clothes I can wear? I mean, go to Walmart and buy him a two shirts and a pair of pants. So he has clothes that fit him. And she goes,
and
I noticed that. I was thinking I'm going to do the same thing, but I don't want to offend the parents. I said, you know what? The kid's getting bullied something fierce at school because his clothes, I mean, I'm sorry.
Internet here.
In the church here.
Now, another cool thing you're thinking about is the ring doorbell. You have one of those. Yeah.
I know. another ball.